for your host, a very funny man, Mr. Carlos Mendez. Saturday night, are you guys ready for some laughs, everybody? Let me hear you. For a real special treat. Normally, each of these comics headlines their own show. We have 10 of them for you on the lineup tonight. So are you guys ready for a comedy show tonight? Yeah. I'm not a good person. I'm not. I try to be. Like the other day, I called up my grandma to wish her a happy birthday. Turns out she slept in later than normal, or as I like to call it, practicing. I've been following the last few of her practice seasons. I think she's gonna get drafted real soon, you guys. Real soon. Hopefully to the Saints. She's much older than me. She might have done some stuff I don't know about. No, it is sad though. It's sad because it's getting to the point where my family and I started talking about how maybe it's time we put her in one of those places where you put old people, what do you call it, a casket. I'm just kidding, you guys. She's already dead. So I was a little late to it, but I finally got to see Jurassic World. You guys see that? Yeah. Great movie. It really brought back the spirit of the original. First half hour was so full of wonder that I was like, wow, this is almost like my childhood. And then, spoiler alert, everything goes to shit. So I was like, oh no, it's exactly like my childhood. That's what it is. I was also watching the Muppets movie the other day, and I realized that Kermit the Frog is the original Chubby Chaser. Groundbreaking television character right there. I want to start a dating website exclusively for Amish people. Exclusively for Amish people. Call it rumspringallupinthatass.com. I love it when there's white folks in the crowd that get that joke. I'm a selfish lover. I don't share my porn with anyone. I also think that sleeping with a girl is a lot like a favorite TV show. When it's fresh and new to you, you love it. You want it to be renewed next season. After a couple of years, it starts to get old and predictable, and you think, well, sure, I don't want it to get canceled. I've already invested so much time into this. But at least add a new cast member or something. I don't know if you guys can tell from that last joke, but yeah, I'm single. Speaking of, they say that desperation is the worst quality a woman can ever see in a man. But I say, why won't you love me? They also say that the way to a man's heart is through his stomach. I think a knife works just as well. You guys are really cool. I feel like I can trust you guys, open up to you, a little bit about me. I wear Ninja Turtles boxers. I wear them because that's the correct response. I wear them because I always want to feel like my balls are safe. But they work, too. They work, because ever since I started wearing them, I haven't been kicked in the nuts, not even once. That's because they protect against the Foot Clan. Cowabunga, little dudes. When I was young, I was still learning, so I used to take everything literally. My teachers used to tell me to dream big. Now look at me. Those total bastards. There's some people that don't like bisexuals, mainly out of jealousy. They're like, it's not fair that they're attracted to both men and women because there's twice the amount of people they can sleep with. Valid point. But I think the worst possible thing to be would be an unattractive bisexual person, because then you'd get rejected by twice the amount of people. That would just suck. If two girls are dating, do they starve to death? Like, what do you want to eat? I don't know. What do you want to eat? I don't know. What do you want to eat? Just an endless loop like those vultures from the Jungle Book? No, who am I kidding, you guys? If two girls are dating, there's always something they can eat, right? Clam bake. So it's Pride Weekend here in San Diego. The Supreme Court finally passed marriage equality. Give it up for that. Yeah. Awesome. But as you can tell on the news, the internet, and those dicks with the picket signs outside the festival, it's still a very divisive issue in this country. But what if you're not sure if you believe in gay marriage or not? Does that make you a fagnostic? before I go, I just want to say that as a Mexican, I think it's totally unfair when minorities get advantages with things like affirmative action, while white people have to scrape by with things like inheritance, medical insurance. God, I hate white people. By white people, I mean Jews and Asians. You guys are a great crowd. Please keep it up for the rest of the comics tonight. My name is Carlos Mendez. I'm gonna be your host this entire evening. The first comic coming up on stage, he's one of the first guys I got to meet when I started stand-up. He just got back from a tour in the Middle East for the troops. Give it up for my good friend, Eric Knowles, everyone.